Hi, everybody. Welcome to this is the DJ Roscoe Sports Show for this Thirsty Thursday, November 30th, 2023. Live from Black Trolley as my son is in speech class having fun. Working on the F sound with the Angry Kitty and Paw Patrol gander playing. So he's having fun with that. And I'm staying warm in the car. I figured I'd do a sports show. Last day of November. Tomorrow is December 1st, the month of Hanukkah, the month of Christmas, of New Year's. My younger brother, Henry Lidvock, he turns the big 3-0, 30th birthday this Saturday, December 2nd. Happy birthday, buddy. Also, Aaron Rodgers, who just returned to practice after just, you know, going down with an Achilles injury less than 3 months ago. It's his big 4-0, 40th birthday on December 2nd. So is Gary Sanchez, former Yankee catcher. He'll be 31. Britney Spears with her crazy knife videos on Instagram. She'll be 42. So wild things, but a lot of fun December 2nd birthdays. But happy birthday, Henry. Love you all my heart. But yeah, it was great to see Aaron Rodgers back at practice. Who knows if he'll actually play, depending on if the Jets are out of the playoff race. It might not make sense. But coming back from the Achilles injury, and just 79 days later, he's back practicing for the New York Jets, and that's incredible. Throwing tight spirals. Even if they're out of it, I would love to kind of just see him go out there and play. But hey, if you can activate him soon, I would love it. Cross our fingers for a miracle, the Jet fans out there, after he, you know, got hurt after just 4 snaps. But we have a lot of fun things to talk about. MLB Hot Stove, some wheeling and dealing. The winter meetings start up, I think, on Monday, December 3rd. Sunday, December 3rd. So that's a lot of exciting wheeling and dealing. The trades, signing, the trades are going to be going like wild. The rumors, all the chatter about what could and could not happen. A lot of it's fake news, but who knows? Where will Shohei Ohtani go? Where will some of the big times, where will Juan Soto go? Will he get traded? What will happen to him? Even though he probably won't sign an extension, so he'll be free agent next year. But will the Yankees be willing to trade for him for 1 year for him to be a one-and-done player? Give him a lot of money for 1 year. Maybe have a great year and trade a lot of top prospects, but lose him. We'll see. There was some minor deals that were happening this week, but not necessarily minor. Some nice moves. Sonny Gray, who was a finalist in the Cy Young Award, American League Cy Young this year, but I think was just behind Garrett Cole, who won in the American League. He signed a 3-year contract, $75 million with the St. Louis Cardinals, an option for year number 4. So he's a talented pitcher besides when he was on the Yankees, but with Oakland, he was good. With the Twins, he was good. With the Reds, he was good. Jason Heyward signed a 1-year contract for $9 million to return to the LA Dodgers. Not what he used to be, but he's still a decent defensive player and can hit the ball a little bit, but not great. Luis Severino is going to stay in New York, go to the Mets, 1 year, $13 million. That news broke last night. Sad to see him go as a Yankee fan, but I hope for the best. I'm glad he gets to stay in New York. A lot of the Yankee players were at Nesty Cortez's wedded over the weekend. That was cool to see. Even Josh Donaldson made an appearance. But Luis Severino had a lot of injuries. 2017, 2018, he was top notch as a dominant pitcher, just couldn't stay healthy. When he did, he was pretty talented. It was pretty amazing. Even the year before, 2022, was very good when he was healthy. But then last year, it was almost at times he was sort of bad in practice out there. I don't know if he was tipping his pitches. It got better late in the year before he got hurt again. But he got hit around pretty badly out there on the mound. But hopefully for the best for him. 1 year, $13 million. Gets $2 million in bonuses he can get if he can achieve certain milestones, if he stays healthy and pitches well. So, hey, maybe he'll redeem himself, stay with the Mets for a while, gets to stay in New York, make good money for a year, and pitch well. But for the Yankees, unless it was like a 1 year, $5 million deal, took a flyer at him. He gets hurt too much and then struggled last year. It didn't make sense the Yankees give him $13 million, especially when they're trying to go after the superstar Japanese pitcher who's been the MVP in Japan for 3 straight years. The Yankees are trying to get him, maybe get Juan Soto. They got a lot of things, though. So Luis Severino, the Mets, 1 year, $13 million. And they also get a nice utility player who played the last 2 years in the division for the Miami Marlins, played for the Tampa Bay Rays before that. Joey Weddle, pretty good, solid player. He can play all over the infield. And probably play a little outfield. Nice lefty bat. Joey Weddle goes to the Mets, 1 year, $2 million. So baseball, hot stove, that will be big with the winter meetings coming up this weekend. For the next week, we'll see a lot of moves. But yeah, definitely interesting to see where Ohtani and where Juan Soto end up. And then, yeah, NBA, we still have the in-season tournament. They're down to, I think, their final 8, the knockout rounds that will be coming up the next few days. And then they go to Vegas for the finals. So that will be pretty excited. And I think you get $500,000 a piece if you win the NBA in-season tournament. So it's a little gimmicky. The courts are a little different colors, but it's kind of fun. The Knicks are in it as a wild card, so we're hoping for the best with that. So that's going on with basketball. Hockey, the Baby Penguins, they played last night at home. I know they're at home this Saturday on my brother's birthday, 6:05 at Mohegan Sun Arena, Casey Plaza, Saturday, December 2nd. Baby Penguins are in action. The NHL, Pittsburgh Penguins playing better of late with Sidney Crosby. They just wondered doing well. Flyers have been playing pretty well of late. The Rangers had a nice comeback victory last night at the Garden in New York City, beat the Detroit Red Wings 3-2. Speaking of the Detroit Red Wings, nice segue. He finished the year last year with the Rangers, but was banged up. Was not the superstar player he used to be with the Chicago Blackhawks. Maybe he'll redeem himself as he's getting older and play close to that caliber of star player. Patrick Kane signed a one-year contract for not too much money for the Detroit Red Wings, so we'll see what he does in Detroit. That just happened yesterday. So hockey news, basketball, baseball, college football. We have the conference championship games this weekend, so that'll be exciting. So the Big 12, the Big 10, the ACC, SEC, the Pac-12, the game's actually on Friday, tomorrow night. That'll be the last Pac-12 championship for at least a while, because it looks like that conference is going to dissolve. A lot of those West Coast teams are going to the Big 10, so it's been pretty wild. And some are going to the Big 12. But yeah, so Big 10, you got Iowa versus Michigan. Michigan beat Ohio State for the third year in a row, and they get Jim Harbaugh back. And I think the Big 10 commissioner is going to have to bite his words and try to force a smile like this. Just like Roger Goodell had to do with Deflategate when he had to give Tom Brady the Super Bowl trophy, that suspended him. So he had to miss the last three games of coaching on the field, but got to coach during the week, and now he'll be back for the Big Ten Championship. I expect Michigan to steamroll Iowa, go to the 14 playoff, and next year goes to the more fair 12-team playoff, so it'll be even more chaotic. Penn State, this was next year, Penn State would be in the playoff this year. But we'll see what happens. I think they'll definitely win the Big Ten title again. They've been crushing Ryan Day and Ohio State for third year in a row, but we'll see Jim Harbaugh coming back. Will they be the team to beat? But can anyone beat the SEC powerhouse at Georgia, who's won two straight national titles, still undefeated? They're going to play Alabama in the SEC championship game, whether they win or lose. I expect them to beat Alabama that game, even though Nick Saban and Alabama are always ready to play. They had a miraculous comeback win, the Iron Bowl, against their rival Auburn last week. But, Georgia is going to be in the playoff, 14 playoff, no matter what. That will be a tough team to beat. Last year, Michigan got upset by TCU before they got destroyed. TCU against Georgia in the national title game. Hopefully, there's not savage blowouts in these playoff games, that they're close, competitive games. And then next year, the 12-seed playoff will be excited. Pac-12 championship rematch of Oregon versus Washington. Washington beat them earlier. Washington's undefeated. Can Oregon return the favor with Bo Nix? You would think that it's possible. I would maybe give them a slight advantage of that. Big 12 championship game should be exciting. SEC championship should be exciting with Florida State, who's undefeated, but their star quarterback got injured, so he's probably done for the year. And that might affect them. Will they even get in the 14 playoff, even if they stay undefeated with that ACC championship? Syracuse did win their last game of the season against Wake Forest, so they are bowl eligible. They're 6-6. I think Sunday you'll find all the bowl games, so Syracuse will get in, and they hired their new coach. Never been a head coach in the college level or any level, but Fran Brown, who's been listed as the top recruiter in all college football, was the defensive backs coach the last 2 years, winning national titles for the Georgia Bulldogs. Kirby Smart, the Georgia head coach, sings his praises, says he'll do a great job, so he'll be replacing Dino Babers. So Fran Brown will be the new coach for the Syracuse Orange. Hopefully he does a great job recruiting the New Jersey native. Hopefully gets some big-time recruits who are willing to come there. So that'll be interesting. They're going to go to a bowl game. Kurt Warner's son, who had 2 great years for the Temple Owls, he will actually be in the transfer portal. A lot of people go to the transfer portal, so people are making their college decisions for playing and for coaching. So Kurt Warner's son, who's done very well for Temple, he has 2 years of eligibility. He's going to the transfer portal. The Duke quarterback is going to the transfer portal. So very interested to see what's going to go with that. But Syracuse is their new coach. They're going to be bowl eligible. Penn State's going to have a good bowl game. They did what they normally do. They dominated everyone. They beat up Michigan State on Black Friday, primetime on NBC. They still lost close ones to Ohio State and Michigan. Next year, they'll play some of these West Coast schools coming to the Big Ten, USC, UCLA, but they won't play both Ohio State and Michigan in the same season. They'll only play one. So that'll be a little bit different. So Penn State's going to wait for their bowl game. That'll be interesting where they go. Notre Dame had a nice win over Stanford. We'll see where they go for their bowl game. So, yeah, we'll find out where the college bowl games are going to be, who's going to be playing them with the local teams and the big national teams, and who's going to the college football playoff, the top four. And we have conference championship games this Saturday. So, very exciting weekend for college football. And then I want to quickly give props and give a big shout out to the Dallas Mountaineers high school football team. They are undefeated. They're 14-0. I covered two of their games this season. They were 10-0 in the regular season, won the Old Shoe game against their rival Lake Lehman Black Knights for the last game of the regular season. And then in the playoffs, they were able to find a way to win three games to win the district championship. And now they won a nice miraculous overtime, back and forth game, won it overtime, blocked the extra point, then scored a touchdown and kicked the extra point and beat Bonner and Prendy in the state champion, state playoff game, state quarterfinal game at home at Dallas Mountaineer Stadium. In the district playoffs, they were able to beat Wallen Paulpeck in the first round, then Nanticoke, and then Valley View to win the district championship. Now beat Bonnie Prendy, and now they will go to a neutral site in the Lehigh in Allentown area, about an hour away from Dallas, and they will take on a big-time powerhouse. I think McDavid it is. So they're the defending champion. So who knows? If Dallas can win, they'll be one game away. If they win, they'll clinch a spot in the state championship game in Hershey, Pennsylvania. So they'll be the land of chocolate, ready in time for the new Willy Wonka movie this holiday season. So congrats to the Dallas Mountaineers, Rich Manello, Coach Manello, great season. All those guys working hard all season long. Buster, but I love how the local community has been standing behind them and cheering them on every step of the way. So rooting for the Dallas Mountaineers, their last local team in the Wyoming Valley Conference, who are still in it, could make it the state championship game and maybe win it all. Have only won the state championship one time 30 years ago, 1993, so 30th anniversary. Fingers crossed, maybe this could be their year, but they will be in the state playoff semifinals for high school football, and hopefully they do well and get to the state championship. But congrats either way. 14-0, undefeated, with the district title, and had a great home win against Bonner Prendy, a really talented, fast team in the state playoffs last week. So congrats to the Dallas Mountaineers and hope for continued success. Then movies, we got to see the Taylor Swift concert with my daughter and I. She loved it. And that will become a streaming service on her 34th birthday on December 13th, her lucky number 13. There's a crazy movie called Silent Night coming out this week. Looks like a violent action movie for the holiday season. And then, you still have Napoleon, you have the Disney's Wish, you have the Trolls movie, Thanksgiving creepy horror fun movie, the Hunger Games movie, and then pretty soon you're going to have the Willy Wonka movie and the Aquaman movie with Jason Momoa, who just hosted Saturday Night Live, coming out right before Christmas. And then this week you have Emma Stone hosting Saturday Night Live, so that'll be exciting. Then Adam Driver and Kate McKinnon, a star cast member, will be back for the final two shows of the year. So that's the entertainment stuff. And now we're going to do, the words of the late, great Heath Ledger, it's the Joker, amazing role in The Dark Knight. You did a great job. Deservedly won the Oscar. And he says, and here we go. Week 13 of the NFL schedule. Hopefully you had a great Thanksgiving. You survived your friends and family. You were able to be able to handle it without going crazy on each other, avoiding politics, avoiding whether it be Trump or Biden, any of that nonsense. We're more alike than we are different. Let's stay together and hopefully have a great holiday Thanksgiving. And now we get ready for the holiday season as we get closer to Hanukkah and Christmas and all that great stuff. So week 13 of the NFL schedule kicks off tonight. Thursday Night Football, Amazon Prime, a video at 8:15 p.m. Al Michaels and Kirk Herbstreit have the call. Seattle Seahawks, they lost. They got beat up at home against the 49ers on Thanksgiving. They both have a full week because they both play a full week off to prepare instead of a short week like most Thursday football games, because the Cowboys also play, of course, like they normally do, them and the Lions every year on Thanksgiving. Cowboys hosted Washington, crushed the Washington Commanders last week. It was close for a while. They torpedoed them at the end of the game. But the Cowboys at home, 8-3 against the 6-5 Seahawks. I think the Seahawks are going to continue to struggle. They'll play the Cowboys tough. This is a dangerous game for the Cowboys. They can't take it too lightly, but I expect the Cowboys to go out there and be close for a while, and then they'll steamroll them and pull away at the end with that dominant defense and Dak Prescott. So always doesn't turn over the ball too much. Him and CeeDee Lamb and Pollard and all the offensive weapons. Ferguson. Cowboys 8-3. They'll move to 9-3. They'll beat on the Seahawks. I'll go with 27-13. They win by two touchdowns at home. Cowboys over the Seahawks sets up a big Sunday night matchup. Cowboys at the Eagles. Cowboys versus the Eagles in Dallas for the rematch. The Eagles won a close one in Philly a few weeks ago, and the Eagles are still 10-1 in the miraculous comeback victory in overtime over Josh Allen and the Bills. That was a great game, and the Eagles now have to play the 49ers in a big game on Rocky Day. So we'll be there for this new Rocky shot by the iconic steps where they have the Rocky statue in Philly. But the Eagles have to play the 49ers now after that miraculous Bills win. And now they'll play the Cowboys the following week on Sunday Night Football. But I think the Cowboys beat the Seahawks 27-13 on Thursday Night Football tonight. Now, for Sunday, December 3rd, there's 7 early 1 p.m. games. 1 o'clock on CBS, the L.A. Chargers at the Patriots. Patriots stick. Now it looks like Billy Zappi will be the starter. They keep benching almost every week. Mac Jones, who keeps struggling. And the Patriots, I think even Bill Belichick is going to quit on the Patriots and go to another team and try to coach with a proven quarterback and see if he can win a championship without Tom Brady, because Brady has won that divorce. Patriots have been a laughing stock. Patriots at home, I don't think they have much of a chance. I think the L.A. Chargers are going to win this game. They've been very consistent. They almost came back to beat the Ravens last week on Sunday Night Football, but I think Justin Herbert and company, the Chargers, they underachieve. I think their coach is going to get fired. Maybe Bill Belichick will be going there. He can scout out the competition when he plays them this week, but I think Justin Herbert and the Chargers are going to light up the Patriots. Patriots couldn't even beat the Giants last week with Tommy DeVito and all the funny memes from Sopranos and all that, and they could have kicked a tie and field goal and missed that. That was an embarrassing 10-7 ugly game. It's two horrible teams. I might be the toilet bowl with the Giants and Patriots. The Chargers are going to beat up on the Patriots. I'll go with 30 to 10. They win by 20 points on the road versus the Patriots. Forget that West Coast, East Coast, 3-hour time difference. They're going to light them up, 30 to 10 Chargers over the Patriots. 1 o'clock on Fox, Detroit Lions have to bounce back after getting upset by their rival, the Packers, who are surprisingly 5-6. Jordan Love played pretty well, beat the Lions on the road to Detroit on Thanksgiving. Lions play on the road against New Orleans Saints. I think the Lions, they'll bounce back. It's an inconsistent Saints team that's still in the playoff race for their stinky NFC South division title, because the Panthers, who fired their coach Frank Reich after just 10 months, 10 games as the coach, they have an interim coach. Panthers stink. Falcons are still, the Saints are still, the Bucks are still in it, and they're all under 500 and stink. But the Saints are, you say, you say there's a chance in dumber terms. But I think the Lions bounce back. Dan Campbell, he motivates so well. The Jared Goff and the Lions will bounce back after that bad show on Thanksgiving. They'll beat up an inconsistent Saints team on the road. I think the Lions win in New Orleans. I'll go with, they score a lot of points. I'd say they'll double them up, 34-17 Lions over the Saints. Falcons over by J-E-T-S, stinky Jets, who are now 4-7 and lost 4 in a row. Black Friday, they got embarrassed. They were about to at least go to a halftime, only down 10-6 after the pick 6 for the Jets, and another reception against Tua, and then he throws it up to Tim Boyle, who was an embarrassment. He's worse than Zach Wilson. He was horrible in college, doesn't deserve his chance in the NFL, maybe XFL at best. He throws up a Hail Mary, it's a lame duck pass, doesn't even go to the end zone, and then he returns it for a touchdown. At any point, if you either just knock the ball down or push him out of bounds, he doesn't score a touchdown, and the Jets at least are only down 10-6. They end up getting blown out by 3 touchdowns. It was embarrassing. I got to watch it all again in horror on the NFL in-season with Hard Knocks with the Miami Dolphins on HBO every Tuesday night. Fun show, but it was embarrassing. Falcons, they're 5-6. They've been inconsistent, but they were able to beat the Saints last week. I don't know what to say here. I'm going to drink the Kool-Aid. I'm going to go with the Jets here, and it's not even very confident. I'm going to say the Jets, out of desperation, they need to win so they can stay somewhat relevant, stay somewhat in the playoff race, because Aaron Rodgers is practicing, but the only way he's going to play if the Jets can stay in the playoff race. So I'm going to just drink the Kool-Aid. I'm going to say the Jets defense will do enough. I have no faith in this pick. I have no faith in Jets offense, but I love the Jets defense. I'm going to say the Jets win an ugly game, 13-10 over the Falcons at home in New York, but I don't know about that one. But I'm just hoping Aaron Rodgers can come back and lead the Jets to the playoffs in my crazy delusional mind with just a few games left of the season. Arizona Cardinals is stink there 2-9 at my beautiful wife's Pittsburgh Steelers, who are 7-4. Had a nice bounce back win. Actually outgained the team for the first time this season. They hadn't done that. Hallelujah. And they did very well since Matt Canada got fired as the offense coordinator. Got over 400 yards for the first time in over 3 years. Never did that with Matt Canada, over 400 yards of offense. They played better, beat the Bengals with their backup quarterback with Joe Burrow out for the season. Unfortunately, hopefully he makes a speed recovery next year with the wrist surgery. I think the Steelers at home, they crush the Arizona Cardinals. If they don't, it's embarrassing. They should win this game easily, get to 8-4. I say the Steelers and James Conner, former Steeler, will be there. I would have said Joshua Dobbs, but now he's on the Vikings. I said the Steelers are going to win this game. They win the very low-scoring games. You can't take it for granted they'll beat up on a bad Arizona Cardinals team, but they should win this game. I'll go with the Steelers 24-13. They win by 11 points over the Arizona Cardinals. 1 o'clock on CBS. Steelers proved to 8-4. The Colts, surprisingly, are 6-5. They're playing pretty well. They beat the Joe Abrams, Tampa Bay Bucks last week. I picked the Bucks last week. Didn't work out well. They play at the Tennessee Titans on CBS 1 o'clock. Will Levis, their young quarterback, played pretty well. Inconsistent, but played well. Derrick Henry can run people over. But I'm going to go with the Colts here. I think Gardner Minshew with the Fu Manchu mustache, he has his team believe in. Jonathan Taylor running back, even though he's been banged up. I think the Colts just find a way to win, even though they've been out their young rookie quarterback, Anthony Richardson, most of the season. I think they'll find a way to beat the Titans in an ugly, close game. I'll go with 20-17. Colts get a field goal late, beat the Titans, their division rivals, and move to 7-5, and are very much in the playoff race, which I would not have thought this late into the season, but a few weeks to go. Dolphins at Washington Commanders, who I think are 4-7. They're terrible. You know, Sam Howell's pretty good. I think Ron Rivera will get fired at the end of the season. Dolphins 8-3. They'll improve easily to 9-3. Mike McDaniel, the head coach, I love watching him on Hard Knocks. He's been fun to watch. The Dolphins offense is explosive with Tua out there at quarterback. Just light it up oppositions. They'll light up Washington, even though they lost Phillips, their star defense player, towards Achilles at the Jets stadium. Seems a lot of people were tearing their Achilles there, just like Aaron Rodgers was there on Black Friday. Got to see that horrible injury. They showed that on Hard Knocks. Hopefully he makes a speed recovery. But the Dolphins offense and defense is underrated. They will crush Washington. I'll go with 38-13. They crush Washington by 25 on the road in the nation's capital. Then at 1 o'clock, the red-hot Denver Broncos, who have won 5 in a row at the Houston Texans on the CBS. I'm going to go with the Texans here, but it's going to be a close one. I'll go with the Texans to win 27-24 by 3 points over Russell Wilson. Just had his 34th birthday yesterday. Happy birthday. Playing well. The offense, defense play much better. Sean Payton has righted the ship. They keep finding ways to win, and they win some close games. The Texans lost a heartbreaker against their division rivals at home against the Jaguars last week, but I believe it's C.J. Stroud, the young rookie quarterback, doing a great job, and I think the Texans are going to find a way to beat the Broncos 27-24. Then there's 3-4 p.m. late afternoon games, 4-5 on CBS. The Carolina Panthers, I mentioned they fired their head coach after just 10 games. Bryce Young, their rookie top pick in the NFL draft, has been struggling. Goes on the road to the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. You got to win this game, Joe. I'll go with the Bucs to beat the Panthers here. I'm going to go with Baker Mayfield, the Bucs, not good, but they'll do enough to stay the thick of things in that bad division. I'll go with 27-10. They win by 17 points at home against the Panthers. 425 on Fox. I'm going to go with the LA Rams at home to actually beat the Browns. The Browns quarterback, who's their backup, DTR, after Deshaun Watson's out for the year, he's in concussion protocol. Joe Flacco, the anxious wonder, who's they picked him up off the scrap heap. He probably will have to start this game. Myles Garrett seems injured. He injured himself last week. They're 7-4 with the Browns with all their injuries. They still have a solid defense, but they might fall apart, especially if they lose Myles Garrett. They lost their star quarterback. I'm going to say the LA Rams at home, Sean McVay and company, and Matthew Stafford, Cooper Kupp, get it done. They win a close game. I'm going to go with 23-20 LA Rams at home over the Browns. 425 on Fox. It could be the game of the day. Could be the game of the year. Rematch last year's NFC Championship game. This year, hopefully, all the quarterbacks stay healthy, not like Brock Purdy and all the quarterbacks last year got hurt. And the 49ers have made a lot of excuses and been talking trash that they're better than the Eagles. We'll see. They're 8-3 of the 49ers. Eagles are 10-1 after that great comeback win. Never count them out, even though it looked bad in the first half. Jalen Hurts coming back against the Bills last week. Eagles at home. I'm going to go with the Eagles here to kind of silence the critics, beat the 49ers. I'm going to go with the Eagles over the 49ers in a close game. I'm going to go with 27-23. Eagles win by 4 points over the Niners and improved 11-1. And Niners improved 8-4. They silenced the Niners and keep talking trash about them. Sunday Night Football, 8:20 on NBC. Chiefs at Packers. First time the great Pat Mahomes comes to Lambeau Field. Packers 5-6. Jordan Love's playing a bit better. But the Chiefs, 8-3. Finally scored in the second half. Hallelujah. Travis Kelce, his girlfriend Taylor Swift, back from the her Eras tour before they start back up in the beginning of next year. Chiefs 8-3. They beat up on the Raiders after going down 14-0. They came back and crushed the Raiders, their division rivals in Vegas, after it looked a slow start. They were struggling again. They weren't scored in the second half. And then the Chiefs can't take the Packers too lightly, but I think they beat up on the Packers. Close for a little bit. They pull away, and I'm going to go with the Chiefs to beat the Packers. I'll go with 31-20, they win by 11 points on the road at Lambeau Field. Chiefs improved to 9-3. Monday Night Football on December 4th, 8:15 on ESPN ABC. The Bengals, who stink now that Joe Burrow is out with their backup quarterback having to take all the snaps. The Bengals 5-6 at the Jaguars. My buddy Dan DeTore's Jaguars 8-3. I think they'll improve to 9-3. Trevor Lawrence will light up the Bengals. Bengals really don't have much hope now with all the injuries. The Jaguars should easily win this game. Don't take them too lightly, but Jaguars at home. I'll go with the Jaguars beating the Bengals. I'll go with 34-17, they'll double up the Bengals. Then there's six teams off this week, all off bye weeks. The Ravens, top seed in the AFC, 9-3 after beating the Chargers. They're 9-3. They're off. Bills 6-6 after a tough loss to the Eagles. They're off. The Bears, 4-8, but nice, but the football win over Joshua Dobbs with 4 interceptions and still almost won the Vikings. Bears won that game. Justin Field, who knows, they'll have the number one pick if they'll get a replacement for him and the quarterback for the Bears next year. They're 4-8. Raiders 5-6, playing better with Antonio Pierce as their coach. They're off. Vikings 6-6. We'll see if Joshua Dobbs is the starter coming off the bye. And then the New York Giants 4-8 have won 2 games in a row after beating Washington and the Stinky Patriots. But Tommy DeVito, former Syracuse quarterback, playing better. And the Giants have a little bit of mojo working, but they're off. So Ravens, Bills, Bears, Raiders, Vikings, and Giants are all off. And again, my picks this week, included tonight, are Cowboys of the Seahawks, Chargers of the Patriots, Lions of the Saints, Jets of the Falcons, Steelers of the Cardinals, Colts of the Titans, Dolphins big over the Washington Commanders, Texans with a close one to the Broncos, Bucks crush the Panthers, Rams over the Browns, Eagles a close one over the 49ers, Chiefs win bigly over the Packers, Jaguars crush the Bengals, and those are my Week 13 NFL picks. We'd love to hear what you say. Take two, call me the morning, it is not a tumor, and things of that nature. Hasta la vista, baby. See, it's more cookie. That's good enough for me. Ah, cookie, 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 such a see. Ah, cookie, 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 such a see. All right, sing a quick song to my amazing wife. We'd love to hear your picks, if you agree, disagree, of my Week 13 NFL picks. And, sing a quick song, my beautiful wife Abby, Lorelai, LJ. Love you all, guys, with all my heart. I'm gonna sing "You Make Loving You Easy." It's our Zac Brown wedding song. You make loving you all I wanna do. Every little smile and every little touch reminds me just how much it makes loving you easy. I sing it, my wife says, "Please don't easy." Well, that's our show. Keep it locked, DJ Roscoe Sports Show. You're home for all your favorite sports entertainment talk right here, DJ Roscoe Sports Show. Oh, I forgot, Good Burger 2 is on Paramount Plus. You can stream that. Leo, fun Adam Sandler animated movie. You can stream that on Netflix. The Kelsey documentary is still great. So a lot of fun things. Virgin River comes back today. A lot of fun things, a lot of fun movies and shows and holiday movies as well. But enjoy the hot stove baseball talk, college football, getting ready for the playoffs, and all the championship college championship games, basketball, hockey, baseball, football. Everything you wanted more. Keep it locked. DJ Roscoe Sports Show. Your home for all your favorite sports and entertainment talk. Right here on the DJ Roscoe Sports Show. Happy birthday, my brother Henry. And love you guys with all my heart, all the family. And love you guys each and every week to tune in to the DJ Roscoe Sports Show. Your home for all your favorite sports and entertainment talk. Right here on the DJ Roscoe Sports Show. Go Dallas, not in the state playoff game. And I'll be covering Penn State's graded basketball against Missouri JV tonight. So have a great weekend and take care, everyone. Bye-bye. We'll see you in December.